reaching them up tall. And keep breathing. Turn towards your left. Maybe you bring that right hand onto the left knee. And then if your neck's okay. legs, you know, rounded everything, pull your navel towards your spine, tuck your chin, tuck your tailbone. Inhale, sink down. Exhale, round it out. Inhale, sink. Exhale, round. Inhale, sink. Back into a child's pose for a moment. Let your hips sink back onto your heels, rest your head on the floor or on your hands. Stay here for a couple of breaths longer. Child's pose is really good to ground yourself as your head is resting on the ground. In most cases, a little lower than your hips. If not, it'll get there. Don't worry about it. And it's also a resting pose, which means at any point you're in your practice, when you need a little breather, that's where you go. With your next inhale, come back up into tabletop. And then with your exhale, tuck your toes, lift your hips up, and back into downward facing dog. Bend one knee at a time here. Find your way into the dog by walking the dog. Maybe sway your hips a little bit. And eventually find stillness. Press all fingers into the mat. Reach your hips high, hold your shoulder blades away from each other, and let your heels sink towards the floor. Your lower back is really tight, just bend your knees quite a bit. If your hamstrings are tight, take your legs wider. Both of those work. And then with your next inhale, bend your knees a lot more forward. bacon on top. Come a lot of bacon right here, but you can feel if your abs underneath are engaged, because that's going to keep your lower back safe. So if I let go here, and then just spill all of this, then my lower back takes quite a bend, and that may be a little too much. So engage here, and that's how we keep our lower back happy. Two more breaths here. Exhale, bring the hands back down on the mats. Tuck the back toes, lift the knee off the mat. Step the left foot back into plank pose. Inhale here. Exhale, lower knees, chest, and chin. Your elbows pull back to go into your hips. The pose may feel a little awkward. It's a beautiful opening for your middle back. Good thing, if you feel awkward about the pose, nobody can see you. Everybody can see me, nobody can see you. So you're fine. Don't worry about it. Bring your next inhale. Scoot your heart forward. Come into baby cobra. Elbows pull back towards your hips. Your upper back muscles are working. One more breath here. Exhale, come back down. Inhale, press into your hands and your knees, tabletop. Exhale, tuck your toes, lift it up and back, and to downward facing dog. Two breaths here. With your next inhale, lift the right leg off the mat. With the exhale, pull the knee into the chest, come forward, and then at the bottom of the exhale, step it through. Low lunge on the left side, or on the right side. Untuck the left toes, knee down on the mat, inhale the arms up. The neighbor's dog is just trying to remind me to say that you need to keep your ankle underneath the knee, and then you want to have your lower abs engaged. You can work with your shoulders in this pose. As you're holding that stretch for your hip, you can also try and engage those arms a little more by pulling the thumbs towards the back, opening your heart space a little more, and then making sure your shoulders are dropped all the way away from your ears so you don't get tension in your neck. Two more breaths here. Come into a high lunge, so inhale your arms up here. And then with another exhale, bring your arms back behind you, interlace your fingers, and then work on straightening those arms. If you can't interlace fingers, you can grab opposite wrists, or you can grab forearms, whatever is in reach. The idea with this is you want to open up the heart space further, so try to make your chest as wide as you can. If you can interlace fingers, work on straightening those arms. If your arms do go straight, work on pulling those hands away from the body. Last inhale here. Exhale, let go of those fingers. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, arms down. Step the right leg back, plank pose. Inhale here. Exhale, lower knees, chest, and chin. you. Can you remember how you interlaced your fingers? This way, you're gonna do it now, is the way that feels slightly awkward, because that's the way you do it less often. So go ahead for the slightly awkward one. That's the other way. And then work on straightening, work on pulling away, or work on grabbing your wrists, whatever is your level for today. Still engaged? Good. One last breath here. Exhale, roll the hands. Inhale the arms up. Exhale, step forward and take forward fold. Inhale from halfway up, right, reach just forward. Exhale, fold back down. Inhale from all the way up to standing, arms reach high. Exhale, lower your hands to your heart. Good work. I'm going to take a big step sideways. I'm going to open up into a wide-legged fold. Not folding yet. Wide-legged so far. Let's fold together. So you're going to place your hands on your hips. And then you're going to inhale and lean back. Press your hips forward and lean back. And then with an exhale, fold forward from your hips. Here you can either rest your hands on the block that I didn't bring today, or on a pillow or on a big book or something, or you can bring your fingertips to the ground if that is in reach for you, or you can push yourself up on your legs. So whatever works for your body today, that's where you go. Props are always an option. I want you to keep a safe home practice. So whatever works for your body, bit of discomfort, no pain. And then relax your neck. If it's easy for you to come down, you can walk your fingertips back until your hands are in line with your feet. And you want to keep your legs active in this pose. So keep those leg muscles engaged. That's going to keep you from overstretching. With your next inhale, walk your hands forward if you have them between your legs. And then bring one hand to the center. If it's hard for you to get the hand down, then use a block or something else to prop yourself up. So right hand in the center, and then left arm goes up. And then you may notice that your hip is trying to do something to follow that. Gently pull that hip back towards the right so it's still centered. If your neck is okay with it, you can follow the left arm with your gaze. And then keep breathing deep here. Two more breaths here. With your exhale, bring that arm back down. Switch hands, and with an inhale, bring the right arm up, twist to the right. Hips gently pull back to the left if you were trying to sneak out. If your neck is okay, look over that right shoulder towards your right hand. Thank you. with your exhale, bend your elbows, bend your knees, reach your heart up. So maybe you've heard of the Wonder Woman pose before for self-confidence. That one is fairly close. Wonder Woman pose is where you have your hands and your hips and you reach your heart forward. And Goddess pose is a little more divine, opening your heart. You're receiving all the blessings, and you're giving all the blessings. So I love this pose. I believe both of them have their value, and both of them deserve to be practiced regularly. And it doesn't matter if you're a male goddess or a female goddess or somewhere in between, it's still just called Goddess Pose. More breaths here. And yes, goddesses have very strong thighs. Inhale, come back up. Relax your hands by your sides. Good work. Maybe gently circle your shoulders. And then we're going to walk the feet in a little further until your heels are about met with the heart, and we'll come into Malasana. So with an inhale, sink down to however far is okay for you. So if you have trouble with your knees, maybe you're staying right up here and you're pressing your hands to keep those knees far apart and get a stretch out of this. If your knees don't give you a hard time, maybe you can come deeper. Maybe at some point your heels will come off the mat. No problem, your heels are off the mat, big deal. You practice here. If they do stay down, then you're gonna come to some point where either you can't go further with your hips or you can't go further with your ankles, and you stay exactly on that first edge. That's where you practice. That's how you find your practice spot. You find the first edge in your body, and then you be patient with yourself. Just hang there. go into a twist from here, and there's two options. First, keep your left hand on that right knee and come to the twist from here by bringing that right arm to the back and then looking over your right shoulder if that is available to you. If that one is fairly easy in reach, then, by the way, falling out of the pose is part of the practice, that's okay. If that is fairly easy in reach, you can take it a little deeper and see if you can reach the outside of that right foot with your left hand and work on straightening those legs. As you can see, my leg does not go all the way straight. I'm still going to show you a perfectly imperfect pose because that's where I am right now, because my right hamstring is not very happy after running too much. And then you still try to look over that right shoulder if that's available to you. You may fall out of it, and then you just get back up. Fell out of it again. Give it two more breaths. With your next inhale, pull that knee back into the chest. Exhale, bring it back down on the floor. Good work. Circle the ankle of the standing leg. And then we'll switch to the other side. So pull that knee up to the chest. And then here's your two options. You can grab the knee with the hand and reach the left arm back. Maybe follow that left arm with the gaze. And focus on keeping those lower abs tight. That's going to help you maintain your center here. And if you'd like, you can work on the version where you take that foot up, the outside of the foot, work on straightening that leg, and then also try to look over that back hand. You'll notice the difference between the left and the right side. One side is more funky, we call it the fun side. And that's okay too. Two more deep breaths here, good work. Exhale, come back to center, pull the knee into the chest, and then bring it back down. Circle that standing leg angle. Very nice. That was play pose number one. Play pose number two, we're going to get back to that first leg, and this time we're going to make a figure four, cross that right ankle on the left thigh. I'm already wobbling, we're not even getting there. This may feel wobbly. If you practice this at home and it's wobbly right here, the first thing you want to do is look at something that doesn't move, which means look at me while I'm wobbling. So just focus on one point, and that's going to make it more stable for you. And then from here, if you'd like to play a bit, bring your hands together and then start folding forward towards that shin. Maybe you can bring your elbows in front of it. Maybe you can hang here. This is a good place to play too. It makes your stretch pretty intense on the outside of that right thigh. And maybe if you want to play a little more, check if you can bring those hands on the floor. I'm going to hop back a little here so I can bring my hands on the mat. And then, if you want to keep playing, you bend that standing leg, you bend the knee, and you lift forward onto those arms, and maybe you can straighten the back leg. And then you pull that leg back in and come back up. So wherever you want to play with this pose, if this is your play, you're like, man, playing? It's still playing, you're balancing on one leg, come on, give yourself a break. We're all just practicing. We're very much in our bodies right now, because we're way too busy with the body to follow any thoughts in the mind. So just hang here and practice with us. Right here, maybe bring the elbows down, maybe bring the hands down, maybe lean forward onto them. Maybe lift the back leg. slowly come out of it. Bring it down onto your knees for a moment. We'll take a short breather here and stretch the soles of our feet so your toes are tucked. And then bring your arms behind you. Maybe you can grab your opposite wrists. Maybe you can try and work those fingers together. So here's option one, grab wrists, grab forearms, grab elbows, whatever's in reach. Or try to get those fingertips wiggled together and then open your heart space. More breaths here. And then with your exhale, let go of those fingers, untuck the toes. I know by now the toes are squeezing as much as the ankles were before. That's okay. Just curl them up a little bit. Say, I love you, toes. We're all still here together. We got this. And then we'll come back up on our feet and do the other side. Stretch for the outside of the left thigh, and it is perfectly fine to stay here. You want to make sure that your weight is far enough back, so don't let that knee come forward too much. Sink the weight towards the back, as if you were sitting down on a chair. And then you can bring your hands to your heart, and if that's available, aim with your elbows towards the shin, and hang here. If you want to take it further, bring your hands down on the mat and then start leaning forward. See how my toes, I don't even know which foot that is now, my left toes are grabbing the upper arm as I lean forward, and then that right leg floats off, and then I can try to straighten that right leg. So it's a little bit like a crow pose, and then you push back out of it. Whichever level, whichever version of this pose you're practicing, they're all equally good for that left hip and for the psoas, for the SI joint. And you decide where you play. You play right here. Make sure your weight is far enough back so that knee stays heavy. You play right here in that forward bend. If you have a little bit more arm strength and this is a reach, this is just fun to play around with. So lean forward, take that weight, and then see if you can straighten that right leg. Good, last breath here. Exhale, stand back up. Move that foot gently, whatever it needs right now. Oh, good work. And then we're going to gently roll down into a forward fold and bring those hands underneath your feet once more if that is in reach. If that is not in reach, you can also bend your knees a lot and see if you can then get your hands under your feet. Your choice to play with. Take the hands back out. We're going to heel toe those feet apart. once more, just for a little moment, just for two breaths right here. And then we're going to take it to Skandhasana. So for that, we're going to bring the right toes facing up. We're going to turn the left toes outward, and then we're going to bend the left knee a lot. So depending on where you're at, maybe this is exactly where you hold the pose. If you can sink in here a little deeper, allow that to happen. You're going to feel a stretch on the inside of that right leg. Maybe at some point your ankle comes off the mat. That's okay. Then you hold it right here. You can use your hands to keep you in place. If the ankle can stay down, you can use that left arm to keep that leg facing outward, and you can bring your hands together. And then with every inhale, you try to sit a little taller. And with every exhale, soften around those hips. And play a little bit with where that foot needs to be. Because sometimes what happens is if that foot is too far out, we have no chance of sinking further down. So in that case, I would have to make that transition a little over here so I can even sink further down. And all of this depends on the flexibility of your ankles, your knees, and your hips. So be gentle with yourself, be very gentle. No need to push. Just be okay with where you're at. As long as you feel a stretch in this leg, everything else don't matter. And if your knee is bothering you in any of these variations, you can also take the seated version of the very same pose where you bend that left knee and you just sit up tall and hang right here. You get that same stretch on the inside of that leg. I'm just a little more in play mode today, that's why we're doing it in a standing version. So last breath here. And then with your inhale, bring your hands back down to center. Center yourself. Maybe just hang out here for a breath. Gently bend the knees on both sides so those hips loosen up. And then we'll do the same pose on the other side. So your left toes come up. Your right knee turns outward. And then find the right distance for you. Maybe you're staying right here. Maybe your hips can bend further down. Maybe you need to adjust where that foot is. Maybe you're just gonna sit right here on your back and instead have the leg laying down in front of you, and you get that very same stretch here. I'm gonna focus on this one. So you sit up nice and tall, no rounding in the lower back, and you can pull on that leg ever so slightly so that you really sit straight, especially if you kind of have a hard time and you feel your back is rounding back here. By pulling on that leg or by pressing into the floor behind you, you can get a little more in here. And if you're up here, then you still have the option of bringing the hands together, using that right elbow to keep the knee out. Two more breaths here. kind of the same way how I wish to treat myself. Like, yeah, I'm going to make mistakes. I'm going to make a lot of them. I'm going to start going off on tangents. I'm going to start thinking about stuff completely irrelevant to what I'm doing right now. And instead of beating myself over the head for that, I just got to gently remind myself, no, that's not what we're doing right now. Just drop the thought. Go back to what you're doing. So see if you can be kind with yourself if you notice that you're wandering off. Last deep inhale here. Exhale. And then slowly make your way onto your belly. From here, we're going to work a little bit on our bow pose. We're going to do that in 3 rounds. For the first round, we're just going to lift our arms up. Our legs are going to stay on the floor. So arms and upper body come up as far as possible. And then you can look slightly forward, but there is no need to keep your neck too much. I'm just turning my head towards the camera so you can actually hear what I'm saying. But ideally, you want your neck to be an extension of your spine, more like this. Two more breaths here. Exhale, come back down. You can rest your cheek on your hands, turning it to one side. Gently rock the hips. And then we'll do the second round. And this will get very uncomfortable if you actually need to go to the bathroom to dress yourself. And then just lift your legs. Your arms and your upper body stay on the mat. So inhale up. And then don't let those legs come too far apart. I just noticed that mine came apart quite a bit. So you want to pull them back together. Keep them close. Last inhale here. Exhale, the legs come back down. And then for the last and third version of this, bring your hands behind you and then grab your ankles from the outside. And then with an inhale, come up into bow pose. You want to pull your feet away from your body and you want to press your ankles up high. You want to reach your heart forward. One more inhale here, good work. Exhale, come back down. Sway those hips left and right. And stay there for a moment longer. I'm gonna try to fix the microphone.
There I was, down on the floor, fixing the microphone, and guess what? It accidentally switched off the recording. So here is a patched together end for the class. We were laying down on our tummies. We were doing bow pose. And from here, we're gonna come up and we're just gonna roll over onto our backs. And then bring our feet overhead, and we're going to come into shoulder stand. Actually, we're going to do plow first. So press your hands into the mat, roll your legs overhead, and keep your legs on your lower back unless your toes touch the floor. If your toes do come down all the way to the floor, you can interlace your hands and work those shoulders a little closer together. And try and work on straightening those legs. If that is not available, any bend in your knees is fine. You're still going to get the stretch out of it. But this is what you want to work towards. You can also put something underneath your legs up here. You can put a block underneath or a bolster or a rolled up blanket. two more breaths right here. And then with your next inhale, get your hands back on your lower back, if they were somewhere else, and then slowly bring your legs up and come into shoulder stand. Your toes are pulling back towards your face, the ball of your feet are facing up towards the sky. All these inversion poses are really good for your vegetative nervous system. They're good for calming you down and at the same time replenishing your energy. Two more breaths here. And then let your legs sink back overhead. Press your hands into the ground and slowly roll out of the pose. Bring your knees into your chest. Make some tiny circles here. And then bring both knees over to your right side. Right hand can go on top of that left knee to hold it in place. That way your lower back can relax here. And then open your left arm up to the side and look over that left hand. With every exhale, see if you can let go a little more. If there is still a little tension that you can release somewhere. Two more breaths here. And then with your next inhale, bring your knees back into your chest. And then switch sides. Bring your knees to the left side. Open your right arm to the right. Left hand can hold the right knee in place in case it's off the floor. And then look over your right shoulder. Every exhale, see if there is still a spot where you can soften a bit. Two more breaths here. With your next inhale, pull your knees back into your chest. And then curl up into a tiny ball. Wrap your arms around your legs. Thank yourself for showing up for your practice today. And then release into Shavasana. Your shoulder blades lay flat against the mat. Your hands are facing towards the sky. Your toes are falling to the sides. Relax your forehead. Relax your jaw. Relax your eyes in their sockets. Relax your shoulders and your hips, your knees and your ankles. And then let your breath wash over you, sink into the back of your body, and fall away. Every time we practice Shavasana, we practice the little death. Same as every night when we go to sleep. We just practice releasing and letting go. It's really important for the integration of our practice that the body can reintegrate everything here. And it's really important for the mind to just completely release. And if the mind tends to hold on to something, just tell it release with every exhale. Your next inhale, slowly come back into your body. Take a deeper breath. Move your fingers and your toes. With another inhale, reach your arms overhead, point your toes. And with the exhale, pull the knees into your chests. And then roll over onto your right side. Feel how you're being held here. You're nurtured. You're supported. And you are loved. Your next inhale, slowly come back up into a seated position. Take a deep breath here. How do you feel now in your physical body? Do you feel a little more loose and limber?
maybe energize them a little tired at the same time. Maybe there is a little more space somewhere. How do you feel in your mental body? Maybe there is a bit more space in between your thoughts. How do you feel in your emotional body? Maybe a little more mellow, a little more peaceful. And then how is your connection to your spiritual body? That beautiful spark of your soul. Maybe put a hand on your heart and feel it. Feel your heartbeat. Any of that made a positive difference. That's why we do this practice. So I commend you for showing up today and for bearing with me as I tackle the audio. I thank you for letting me guide you through your practice today. I hope to see you soon. And be well and take care and keep on loving. Namaste. Thank you so much for joining today. I love to hear from you, leave your comments, leave your feedback, leave some requests of what you would like to see in a future class. Thank you so much.